Now you get access to the source code. You can very importantly modify this source code in your own way and use it for your benefit. And the third and the very important point about an open source software is you have to maintain the integrity of the original owner. That means if a particular piece of software was meant for a particular intent, say it was meant for a good purpose, to serve the public, you cannot use that particular code to destroy the public for something else.
Yeah, I would like to start by mentioning stuff like such important tools that were created because of open source. The most popular one being Blender, that is used by architects, software design, designers, group, car modeling, etc. It's an open source software that has become so popular, and the only reason it's so popular is because it's free compared to the paid alternatives that already exist. Collaboration and knowledge is done. Over 56 million developers are using open source software on GitHub, etc. It fastens developer cycles. A study in 2010 by Black Duck was created to prove that 65% of companies switch their software to open source because it increased their speed by about 60% their development cycle. Now a key point that I'm pretty sure the opponents are going to bring up is people believe that it because everyone can see the code, people can...
I feel that open source software is a threat, that because it can be accessed by anyone and can be exploited by the good minds, so-called good minds, and may threat the user, the future users who might be confused with the original and the exploited version. And some organizations they can maintain the codes and fix their bugs, and they can take your personal information and so on.
Open source software license typically contains a printer period of warranty, and it has no liability or protection. It is free, but your information can be passed through it.
Okay, so our opponents mentioned that the open source software can be accessed by anyone, true, and it can be changed and for bad reasons. But when you're downloading an open source software, you're supposed to give them details, okay, about yourself. And secondly, you get an open source software license that you have to obtain for this particular open source software. So just because you're changing the license, that doesn't mean, just because you're using it for a wrong purpose, that doesn't mean you can't be caught. Because you have that particular license, your details are uploaded to the original owners. Secondly, either than the details that you're giving them for that particular software that you're procuring, okay? There is no other information that is taken by the open source softwares.
Okay, to bring up some points that you mentioned, that it can be exploited by people, right? So it's a misconception because it's very counterintuitive that if someone can see the code, they can find exploits and then they just, use that against the users. But because it is open source, a lot of people that are working in the enthusiastic community patch those bugs very quickly. And the major, some examples are the bug bounties that are held by companies like PayPal recently, where there was a major bug that was found by someone else because they made that particular component as open source. One more thing that I need to mention is the Heartbleed bug in OpenSSL, which is a very integral part of the web dev community, and they have patched it just because OpenSSL made that open source. Another thing that you mentioned is that people can inject wrong code and access their data. Well, that is not allowed because if you are downloading open source, you have to download it either from the official GitHub repository that is given to you or the official site. For example, Blender, yes, I can put some wrong code and put it on another repo, but we know that the official Blender.org that you have to go to download the repo and you download your packages. So the idea of you saying that it's going to be exploited does not hold value, because when you're using open source, you have to use it truthfully and usefully and correctly, unlike just like everything else on the internet.
But everyone out there will not think ethically. They may think unethically and may manipulate.
That is based on individual to individual. So you can think ethically or unethically, but the fact that that if a person thinks unethically, suppose a person thinks unethically, we can track him down and we can penalize him for that particular person. So, and if you're downloading a particular open source software from illegal sources, then you very well know what you're doing. And that is not considered a part of this particular open source software or this particular forum.
No, I'll just add to this point. When you mentioned that someone can do upload some wrong code and no one's going to check it, right? So when you upload some code in open source software, it is not directly uploaded to the main repository. You create a branch. So that only after it is verified, then it is attached to the main program, to the main application. So you cannot just write any code and just upload it. There are many checks that have to be made before pushing it to the repo.
But what if something parallel to the app is made? Means I copy the app and just add some my thoughts and launch it with some, means copy the app.
Yeah, so where will you host it? On some website, right? So that is not the official website because you can't do it. The owner won't allow it. So if you are downloading the software, you have to only download it from the official site, and that's a standard rule for the internet across, like even Facebook.com. You have to go to the HTTPS logo or whatever it is. So if you are using it, you download from the official site. That point does not hold.
Questions?
A few more points that I would like to make is a lot of plugins that I created for a lot of applications like PS Code or Blender. These are not really well open or made for like paid software like Adobe. So the community that uses the free software also gives back by making plugins. For example, if the software is not there, they don't have to entirely work on the entire main source code of the software. They just make plugins, and a lot of plugins have made development so much better for people who cannot afford to pay for these expensive softwares like Adobe and other companies are selling. And that is why we believe that yes, open source software is the key for innovation and creativity in the software industry, and we stand with that.
Concluding
remark, 1 minute.
1 minute each.
So finally, our team would like to conclude that we see an open source code as an opportunity for innovation because it is a non-paid software that you're using. You're allowed to modify it. And thirdly, you can be tracked down if you go along any unethical means. And therefore, considering India, for example, that which is a very, it's a spend concerning economy. We would like to go for something that is free, that is something that is legitimate. And therefore, this increases the opportunity for innovation in a place like India where most of the population is young, is enthusiastic, and it is motivationally driven. Thank you.
I would like to make a final point in my closing statement that a great point that's brought up when they say that it's a threat to the software industry is because if I make my software open source, another company, could I finish this?
Yeah, finish.
Another company could take my code and sell it as if it's their paid application. There are many citations and there are a lot of laws and regulations, the major being open source certificates that are attached to your GitHub repo and stuff. So if any company uses my code to sell it as if it's theirs, I can easily sue them and I will find justice because it has been done over the past so many times. Thank you.
Open source software can be used unethically by some people and they can manipulate many things in that, and that could be something to the original owner because it may decrease their customers' future, the people referring them in the future.
It might use the multiple IDs for tracking down the system.